We say goodbye to a big flare player as it rotates beyond the western limb, and hello to another that's just about to return. Those stories and more in the news this week. This space weather forecast is sponsored in part by Millersville University. Come get certified in broadcast space weather. Visit millersville.edu/swen. Space weather this week calms down just a little bit when it comes to big solar flares. As we take a look at our Earth-facing disk, you can see region 3088 rotating off of the Earth's west limb here, but not before it goes wham right there and fires off one parting shot. This is a very big flare, and it launched a massive solar storm that actually became a halo in coronagraphs. But don't worry, this solar storm is headed away from Earth, not towards it, so we're not going to see anything more. Meanwhile, region 3089, which is still a big flare player, is kind of quieted down a little bit. We're going to wait to see if it rotates, as it rotates to the sun's west limb, if it kind of picks up its mojo again and begins firing big flares. That is possible. Also, look in the north, we have a coronal hole. This coronal hole, about a month ago, gave us some decent storming, and so we could get some decent fast wind from this again starting around the 4th. So we're going to be paying attention to that for aurora photographers. And then behind that, if you look at the east limb of the sun, you can see some bright regions here, kind of some glowing stuff in the back that haven't really rotated into view yet. But if we take a look at the sun's far side, this is stereo A, and it's looking at the sun just a little bit from the side. You can get your bearings. You can see region 3088 kind of rotating off of the west limb there in stereo's view and launching all those storms. 3089 is in center disk, essentially in the south. But look at all these regions as of about the end of the month on stereo's east limb. These are regions 3078, old region 3078, which was a big flare player, along with regions 3081 and 3083, possibly. And we are seeing through the far side helioseismology that these regions are still well developed. They also look to be firing off big solar storms, so they could easily be big flare players, which means we are basically trading one big flare player for another. So amateur radio operators and emergency responders, get ready. It looks like we're not going to get that long of a reprieve before radio blackouts could be back on the menu, and this means we have to be careful with space traffic and radio comms, and this includes GPS users, especially anywhere near dawn or dusk. Switching to our moon, we are now coming out of the new moon phase on our way to a first quarter, and by the 5th, the moon will be about 70% illuminated. So you night sky watchers, if you want to catch those dim objects in the sky, like, I don't know, maybe some aurora from some fast solar wind from a coronal hole that's going to hit right about on the 4th, you're going to have this bright companion, so you're going to need to check your local rise and set times. Switching to our solar storm conditions and aurora possibilities over the coming week, we are kind of settling down from the big flare player and all of the solar storms that were thrown kind of partly at Earth, but pretty much went south and west of Earth. So maybe the sun will make up for those fizzles this week. We do have a coronal hole that's going to be rotating in through the Earth's strike zone in around the 4th or the 5th, and that could send us some decent fast solar wind. This is the same coronal hole that we saw about a month ago, and it gave us some decent storm conditions. So right now, NOAA's expecting unsettled conditions at high latitudes, but we could see a minor storm and possibly even major storm conditions. As a matter of fact, maybe about a 60% chance of major storm conditions at high latitudes. At mid-latitudes, once again, it's quiet right now, but the extended forecast, really, we could jump up to active, possibly even minor conditions, with about a 30% chance of major storm. And this could last over the 4th, maybe the 5th, 6th, before things begin to really settle down. So aurora photographers, let's hope the sun is going to help make up for the solar storm fizzles that we saw last week. Switching to our solar flare and particle radiation storm outlook over the coming week, region 3088 is finally rotated to the sun's far side, and that means flare risk has dropped significantly, but we do still have one big flare player on the Earth-facing disk, and that's region 3089. But this region has been sleeping for a little while and likely will do so for another day or two before potentially waking up. Meanwhile, NOAA is giving us about a 25% chance of M-class flares, with about a 5% chance of X-class flares over the next few days. days. And if region 3089, as it rotates to the sun's west limb, begins to wake up, just like region 3088 did, then we could see this risk rise along with the solar flux rising just a little bit. So be aware that radio blackouts are still on the menu, and this means GPS reception could be a little bit dicey in and around dawn and dusk. And amateur radio operators, you also have to deal with these potential radio blackouts and a lot of noise on the bands. And then also, just know over the next maybe 3 or 4 days, we're going to have new regions rotating in from the sun's far side on the east limb, and that will also make the risk rise for big radio blackouts, as well as have that solar flux rise as well. So we're just going to have to stay vigilant. The one good thing is that at least for the moment, the chances for radiation storms are way back down into the green. We're back into the D1 minor range, normal range rather, and that means everyone who is a frequent flyer or flies long duration over the poles, you're all in the clear. So the space weather this week is definitely calming down compared to last week. We say goodbye to region 3088 as it rotates beyond the sun's west limb, and we say goodbye to all those series of solar storms that kind of all went south and west of us and fizzled out a little bit. Let's hope the sun makes up for it with that returning coronal hole that's going to send us some fast solar wind. If it can give us the storming like it did last month, wow, Aurora photographers, we could be in for a decent show, both at high latitudes and mid latitudes. So definitely keep your batteries charged. And now, amateur radio operators and emergency responders, well, you should be going, thank goodness region 3088 is kind of behind the far side and is blocked from view, because that means the noise on the radio bands goes down a bit and we don't have to worry quite so much about radio blackouts. However, this may only last for a few days before we have region 3089 pick up again where 3088 left off, and we have new regions that are going to be rotating into view, and these were old regions 3078, which was a big flare player from last time, and possibly 3081 and 3083. These are all returning regions potentially that gave us some fun noise on the bands and gave us some radio blackouts last time. So be aware that this reprieve could only last maybe a few days before things pick up. And now, you GPS users, well, you know, enjoy the period of time you've got right now. We don't have too many radio blackouts, so dawn and dusk should be all right. And right now we don't have any solar storms, so things even on Earth's night side should be pretty good. But starting around the 4th or the 5th, be aware we're going to get some solar storming, and that means GPS could be dicey anywhere near Aurora, anywhere near dawn and dusk, and your drone flyers, definitely make sure to calibrate your magnetometers often. I'm Tamitha Scove, the Space Weather Woman. Thank you for watching.